Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3 Blind. I am the RPG chick. Going ahead to Anderson's apartment. For some reason we cannot do that through the mass transit hub or whatever you call it. We have to go in through here. Should I get to her really quick? Let me get to her really quick. Chakwas. Well, you should be getting your medical supplies shortly.
You always pull through, Commander. We've received the supplies from Tactus.
Everything good?
Indeed. We've acquired some very useful equipment. As such, I've been able to enhance the effectiveness of our Medigel delivery systems. I've also collated information that Liara may find of interest. Check with Cliff.
Medigel upgrade. Efficiency increase, huh?
So, Udina finally went over the edge. I never really liked the man. Now I know why. Hello, Commander.
Ditto. Now I know why as well. I don't know, should we check with everyone quick? I wasn't going to. But now she's telling me to go see Liara. Alright, hold on. Let me check with Garrus.
Not right now.
Okay. I'm only checking in here because Chakras told me to look in here.
Excellent find, Commander. The information network terminal has been updated.
Good. Huh. This minor surgery will erase all scarring from your cybernetic implants. We already got rid of that in Mass Effect 2. If you forgo any cosmetic improvements, you will instead get a small boost to your overall health. I look fine. I can't see myself. I'm too close to something. I don't have any scarring. I guess this would be if I didn't already fix it in Mass Effect 2. But I did, and that should carry over. I shouldn't assume either. Okay. Now I have so many things at 5%. Are we ever gonna get anything on 10%? I always click that none thing.
Hello again. Hello again.
List of recent purchases by Zaid Masani. RMAX Arsenal Incendiary Grenades, bulk purchase. Thermal Clips, bulk purchase. Metagel is a bulk purchase. M451 Firestorm Fuel, bulk. Ablative Armor Plating. Hain Kadar Field Rations. Casa Fabrication Weapon Repair Kit. Mont Milgram Triple Distilled 45-Year-Old Scotch Whiskey, 2 bottles. Rifle Parts Discontinued Avenger Series. Yes, he is old school. Our friend Zaid. Actually, never really liked him that much. I never really enjoyed all his stories about how he, you know, would brutally kill somebody, this and that. Oh. Excuse me. She doesn't have anything to say.
A little busy right now.
Oh, how rude. It's just real quick, guys. I don't know. They're down in the stairwell still. Let's see if something else plays out.
Shepard.
Commander?
Doing a Legion. Shepard Commander. Alright. Nothing's really changed. They haven't even moved since... from before.
Commander.
So...
Commander.
I wanted this to be the Javik side. Let me just look on a Javik. And then we'll go. Yes, if he doesn't say anything, then we know.
Commander.
Because he always has plenty to say, so that takes care of that. Okay, so the interesting thing is that we have so little to do. This is crazy. Guessing this is either bugged or this is to be found somewhere along the way, maybe on this priority mission. Server ciphers. This is the shore leave. The Normandy is due for retrofits and the crew has earned shore leave. Bring the Normandy to the Citadel and visit Admiral Anderson's apartment. So I'm wondering if you're going to be hanging out more with the crew. During that, because we kind of already did that, right?
Commander?
Alright, let's go. We had to come back here. For some reason. In order to dock and go here. Hello?
Commander, I've got Admiral Anderson on the QEC. Patching him through to you now.
Is that a bug? He's not here?
Shepard.
Admiral, how you holding up?
Day by day, Commander.
Yeah. Hackett sent me a message about this apartment.
I want you to have it. Take it off my hands.
Are you serious?
Thank you.
You need a place that's yours. Somewhere to recharge. Clear your head. Kaylee wanted us to settle down there. Thing is, the longer I'm on Earth, the less I want to leave.
Hmm.
And I want as few loose ends out there as possible.
He's stalking us through the place. Thank you. I'll accept it.
That's very generous.
It's practical. We need you in the best shape possible. Rested. Focused.
Mm. If you say so. Thank you.
And make yourself at home, dammit. It's yours now.
I'm sure I can manage.
Okay, good. Been meaning to do that for a while. I'll talk to you soon.
That's one hell of a fireplace. It's like four fireplaces put together. Take care.
Be careful out there, Anderson.
You too, Shepard.
Explore the apartment. Okay. Notes for Anderson biography relationships.
You never asked me about this. But it's not even about military and non-military, dammit, it's spaceflight. Spaceflight. Finding the mass relays, miracles of engineering. Human imagination rising to meet our desires. We pay a price for that curiosity, that drive. Our relationships suffer. People we love suffer. But that's reality, and it's worth the cost. I must have thought it was. I guess I still do. In the end, you just have to hope you made the right choices.
Hmm. Got some kind of message over there. What's this? Notes for Anderson biography, Normandy.
The Normandy? A brand new ship. My ship. You don't forget that moment. The first time you're standing there. The whole crew looking to you for direction. Unforgettable. I'd led men in
She's like emphatically agreeing.
But if you're lucky, really lucky, you find yourself on a good ship, in front of a good crew, a crew you can trust with your life. Gifted, disciplined, brave, all of them eager to set sail into the endless black ocean. I still remember my XO asking what my orders were. Shepard, I said. Let's see what we can find.
Captain Kirk said that at one point. Let's see what we can find, didn't he? Wasn't it Kirk? Stereo control. Do the shepherd dance. I am going to check that message. I just want to look around. Notes for Anderson biography, Shepherd.
Sure, I can talk about Commander Shepherd. Deep topic.
There's
been a lot written about the commander, but most of it isn't true.
What's in here?
People are quick to judge.
I want to open these.
They don't know the whole story. I don't even know the whole story. But I know the woman. Worked with her. Fought with her. Trust her with my life.
Some lights. Thanks.
To fight a lot of battles alone. God only knows how she got out of some of that.
They go too far away? It sounded like he cut off.
Sure, I can talk about Commander Shepard. Deep topic.
I can't
space
through.
Into
a knife.
Quick to judge. They don't know the whole story. I don't even know the whole story. But I know the woman. Worked with her. Fought with her. Trust her with my life. Shepard's had some rough patches. Who of us hasn't? She's been forced to fight a lot of battles alone. God only knows how she got out of some of that. Makes your head spin. Thing is, few people know what Shepard's been through. I'd like to think I come pretty close.
Maybe.
I worry sometimes she forgets. There's a whole bunch of people who lose sleep over her getting back home. Maybe it doesn't need to be said. Maybe we're too dumb to say it. Soldiers like the commander are rare. Women like Shepard, even more rare.
He really loves talking, doesn't he? Now this turned it off. I wanted to have it play like in that room. But that's not the way that works. More fire? Place is gonna burn down. Anderson, A&N interview.
A few months ago, I had a chance to sit.
Oh, this Al Jelani lady, I remember her.
Decorated soldiers, Admiral David Anderson. He was kind enough.
I want to make her look at it.
And talk about his career. Today the Admiral is on Earth, leading the defense of our home against the Reapers. We have no communication with him or any soldiers on Earth, but we can't forget what they're doing for us.
So how is this an interview then?
Tonight's show is dedicated to all of the soldiers out there, fighting and dying to keep us safe. Admiral Anderson, today marks the 30th anniversary of the N7 program. Can you describe your first day of training in this now famous program?
Earlier interview?
The Interplanetary Combatives Training Program is all business from day one.
How so?
We're given basic gear, then separated and stranded on an asteroid with no nav data. The test ends when the last person runs out of oxygen.
Sounds daunting. What happens to the ones who run out of air first?
Out of the program. The best N7s can survive alone, but work together to survive even longer.
That's very impressive, Admiral. Deep space survival training. Well, that has to be so difficult. All of it would take such strength of character. Well, just plain strength. But then you seem like a strong person.
I'm sorry. Is there a question in there?
She talks more than he does.
Does the program make the man, or do you think you were born for this?
What can change the nature of a man? He's right.
Something like that.
Do you trust your intuition? I mean, do you follow your heart over your mind?
It depends on the day. No, I suppose if I were to be honest, I do trust my instincts. The problem is, war isn't orderly.
Oh, chaos. Well, there should be video. Why do we listen to, like, the radio? This stuff is, like, going on. I'm like, it's, like, boring me. I'm sorry, guys. Let's listen to enlisting. It's nothing, you know. It's, I don't know. It's nothing interesting. It's just basic information. Stuff that we already know about him. I liked the one about Shepard, though. That was interesting. But enlisting? Books.
What was I talking about? Early days, right?
Mm-hmm.
People ask why I joined the military. Everyone talks about honor, duty, sure. But that's never the whole truth. It's 100 little things that add up to commitment. I joined because of a dog. A dog. This patchy, mean son of a bitch that used to bark at me every day on my way to school. He'd snarl and I'd start running. I was just a kid. I remember being in a bad mood one morning. Angry, I can't recall why. When that dog started in on me, I snapped. Started barking right back. We both kept at it until we had nothing left. Dog never bothered me again. Why'd I join the military? Sometimes you just gotta howl to make things right.
Now that was a little more entertaining, I'll give it that. We got a message here. Catalog. I don't know. I have a hunch I'm going to check that last. I want to look around the rest of the place first. I have a hunch that's going to start off something. It's got catalog here, though. Oh. We can customize everything here? Well, before I customize stuff, let me look and see what it looks like now. These are all like his medals and stuff, right? We gotta give that back to him. Contact? Anderson biography, contact.
No, no, it's fine. I got a few minutes.
Of course he does.
War? Yeah. I was there. My first real combat. First for a lot of us.
Look at the art.
One night early in the war. Strapped to my seat as our transport approached the LZ. Everyone was dead silent. Just the sound of breathing. Good men. I trained with all of them. We were always joking and horsing around, but not this time. Just the rattle of the shuttle. And that heavy breathing. Everyone was thinking the same thing. We're off to fight alien invaders. Aliens. Think about that. We all grew up wondering what was out there. If we were alone in the universe.
And hope you're gonna... Now you gotta kill him.
And we were in trouble. Though there we were. About to face an enemy as different and unknown as we could imagine. I knew I had to say something. Keep the men relaxed.
Turians, right?
So I turned to the soldier.
First contact one?
Hendrix, I think. And asked him how his mother was doing. Fine, he said. Why? Because I heard your mama so ugly the Marines thought she was a Turian. Almost shot her.
Your mama's so fat.
Anderson, I heard it was a picture of your mama that started this goddamn war in the first place. Scared the Turians shitless. Everyone had a good laugh at that. And the boys fought great that night. Sometimes that's all it takes. A joke and pat on the back. Just a little reminder that everything's gonna be okay.
Just a reminder that your mother's ugly as sin. Let's go upstairs. Is that something? Yeah. Oh wait. We haven't been in here. These almost look like dentist chairs. Ooh. That's the first one I looked at. Alright, let's see what is upstairs. Is this like a bar? Oh, there's something here. N7. Anderson biography, N7.
Embarrassing moment? I've got more of those than anyone will ever know. Only way to learn something. But if I had to pick one to share... I had just gotten promoted to N7. Full of myself. King of the castle. Found myself buying drinks for undesirables in some rundown bar in the wards.
Where's the voice coming from?
They toasted my recent promotion.
Oops.
I was outnumbered. Things didn't look good. My plan to get out of there involved lots of punching. Well, that worked for a while. Then a table hit me. Or I fell down. When I came to, I saw a Salarian putting the rest of the troublemakers down. A Salarian? Moved like a damn cat, I swear. When everybody was out cold. Or running. He walked over and helped me up.
I could see them being quick.
Yes, sir, I replied. He looked over my collection of unconscious friends, nodding. Not bad, human, he said. Then he walked away. I had met my first Spectre. Learned an important lesson that day.
Salarian Spectre.
How good you think you are. There's always somebody quicker, faster, and a hell of a lot smarter than you just around the corner.
Very nice, Anderson, very nice. Oh, don't get stuck. Alright, what's up here? That'll just turn it off, right? We got more art. A weird metal bug type thing from Klandathu. Let's go this way. Oh god, his childhood? This guy goes on and on. These statues, these busts though. A while ago.
The last of three children born to Ursula and Paul Anderson. A nurse and a flight mechanic, respectively. But that's a little dry. Someone's gonna spice this up, right?
Please do. That's downstairs. More notes. Sorry guys, this is going to be this whole friggin' episode just listening to his notes. But we gotta hear it, right? Can't just leave it out. Pinnacle Station.
Skill and discipline come together in a way that's second to none. Not that I'm faulting our own people or training. It's just that after fighting Taurians in the First Contact War, years later, I had the opportunity to observe and train on Palavin. It was a turning point for me. And I would encourage any soldier to try it.
It was a Turian point for him. Well, that's honorable. Could have been the other way around and he owes you money. But you actually want to pay him back. What a guy. This is the other stairs down that we saw from down there. Bathroom. Can we... I can't go in there. This could be a problem. I can't get in the shower. I can't use a toilet. Anderson! Let me out of this place. The bed! Is this the last one? Normandy SR-1.
You asked me to talk about the SSV Normandy. The Normandy SR-1.
Wasn't there another one about Normandy? I know that.
CEO, Eli Zander, was no diplomat. She ran out of patience with Taurian posturing and politicking during construction. The chief architect of the Drive Corps, Octavio Tatum, and his team of Taurian engineers were in the CIC for final training exercises. Tempers flared when Zander pushed the limits of the stealth system, waiting to vent the IES well past what Tatum was comfortable with. I tried to calm the situation, but it still ended with the Turian scientist in shock. Funny now, when I first laid eyes on the Normandy, she was the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
Then you saw Shepard. Bastard. Okay, we are almost done looking around. There's something in here, though. Oh, it's an armor locker we can do, and weapon bench. Our weapons are here. Our mods are installed. Got to see this one to check. So, a second bedroom. Oh. You know, it'd be great if we could, you know, have an animation if we're going in the hot tub. I mean, geez, in Dr. What's-His-Name's apartment, you could actually use the shower and stuff. And you'd look wet for a few seconds. Not so here. Alright. Let's go see what message we have. Oh wait, I missed something. Was that there? Punching bag? Oh, new questions? Oh, I missed this room. Like a linen closet or something. Let's, yeah, play another one. Great, yay. Minutes later. Next question. Oh, okay.
You're referring to the way I arranged to have the Normandy released to Commander Shepard before the Battle of the Citadel. I'm not sure how valuable hindsight is to the military. Obviously, it worked out for the best. Without the Normandy and Commander Shepard free to do what they needed to do, what we needed them to do, Saren might have taken the Citadel.
That's right.
I think it's clear what a different galaxy this would be if that had happened.
A sucky one.
If I had been wrong, I would have gladly accepted the repercussions.
Well, so would we have all.
The real trick is never being wrong. If you're looking for more action and less philosophy in these notes, let me know.
Alright, so three bedrooms, one bathroom. Wait. Nope, two bathrooms. We've been in here. Okay, I missed that. Alright, oh, where's this message? Here. Oh, wait. Catalog. Bedroom. Standard vanity. Customize the bedding. Black satin bedding with silver white accents for a luxurious night's sleep. It's already there, though. Kitchen. Walnut cabinetry and white countertops for a classic look. Is this stuff already here, though? Maybe you could buy different ones with DLC or something. Customize the seating. White couch with light brown accents. A consistent seller. I don't know if we're going to be coming down here. Coffee tables. Large striped wood coffee table. Wall decorations. Standard shelving provides additional storage for your living space. Look, we're really gonna... Oh, wait. Accent wall made of polished chestnut wood panels. Still have a choice of two, I don't know. Alright, let's see this. Dinner at sushi place on me. Joker. Hey Shepard, I've got a few things I wanted to go over with you. With the Normandy in dry dock, I figured we could meet up at that Ryushi sushi place down the wards. I hear it's the best. Joker. Meet Joker. Okay. Okay, so there's more stuff with friends. Yay. Meet him there. So I guess we just leave the apartment to do that. Oh wait. Arma or Armax Arena. Cool. Rose and Cod materials. I like this view. Really awesome. What's it called? Like Tiberius Tower or something like that? Can't see the first letter.